Okay, so let's look at the simulation results. And by the way, there are a number of experiments that can be performed using EDGCM. One of them is the doubled CO2 experiment that we just talked about, and you can see how there are various settings. You can tell the model what component, what ocean model to use, a mixed layer model with a parameterization of heat fluxes, or a simpler model if you choose to do so. You can change how vegetation and topography is parameterized. So there are lots of different settings in the model that one can change. And there are various determined experiments that you can just run off of the main menu in EDGCM. But if you liked, you could design your own experiment. You could set all of these settings to use the particular version of the model that you want to use. You could specify exactly how to change forcings, whether they be natural forcings like CO2 or other anthropogenic forcings, methane, and CFCs. You can change natural forcings like solar output or even the Earth orbital geometry changes that we know are important on very long time scales. So there are a variety of experiments that you can perform, and a number of the sort of predetermined experiments are indicated here. You can simulate the last ice age. You can simulate snowball Earth. We've alluded to the fact that in the past, there were periods in Earth's evolution where we believe Earth was entirely frozen. And you can do that snowball Earth experiment with EDGCM. But we're going to continue to analyze this CO2 doubling experiment that we were running. And we will look at the output now. As you can see here, we'll do that in a moment.